Hello folks, welcome back to the SFOM channel and thanks for tuning in. In this particular video I want to share some early results of some galaxies that I have been trying to capture with my wide field setup, my 18mm refractor. And also I have recently bought a new mini PC and I had to install all of the software that I normally use for my astrophotography hobby. So I will show you that new solution that I'm using right now. And also I will show you all of the software that I have installed on this new mini PC to engage in my astrophotography hobby. So I hope you like that. And without further ado, let's get into it. So first, let me show you my excellent cable management system. not so excellent actually, but anyway, I was trying to use a USB 3.0 hub, but it didn't connect all of my my gear. So I'm using separate cables that run to my mini PC. And I will start with the Celestron AVX. So this is my mount. And this is an old one. So I have an old Celestron Nexstar hand controller. And this is like this JR11 plug to a RS232 connection, which you can see over here. And so I have bought a RS232 to USB converter, and then I connected the USB cable to it. And this USB cable, it is plugged into my mini PC. And then I have, of course, also the gyroscope here. So I'm using an Orion 18mm gyroscope with my ZWO-120 color camera. It's being used as a guide camera. And I run a second cable, a USB cable, to my mini PC, as you can see here. And then the third one is actually my imaging camera, the ZWO-1600 Mono Pro. And I run here a third cable to my mini PC basically. And also you see here this connection, USB connection. It has the ZWO 8 position filter wheel, the electronic filter wheel, connected to my ZWO 1600 Mono Pro, so that you don't need a separate power source. So that's nice. And then yeah, actually, sorry about that. So my shed is one floor below this one, because I'm actually imaging from my terrace, as you can see. Let's go down and let's check out the mini PC that is in my shed at the moment. So I have this new solution where you can see these beautiful three cables running down. As said, I'm planning on buying a good USB 3.0 hub. So if you know a high-speed 3.0 connection, please let me know. And then I have here, oh yeah, this is a Xiaomi M365 Pro scooter, electric scooter. I have to recommend that to everybody. And yeah, this is just a mini PC that I bought from the second-hand marketplace online. So this is, I don't know even know exactly, it's a Hewlett Packard Elite Desk. There were many of those on the market for only about 200 or 300 euros. Yeah, you can see it has like 4 USB connections. Yeah, and I have power in the shed, so I can just power it up. So hi folks, I just wanted to share all of the software that I have installed on that mini PC. And the first thing I want to show you is TeamViewer. I'm always using TeamViewer to remote connect to my mini PC. And yeah, before I go on, I just have to mention that I will be talking about a lot of different software that I installed on that mini PC, and I will provide links to those software packages in the video description below. So if you're interested in downloading anything, you can just check out the video description. And the first thing I use is TeamViewer. So you can see that I am logged into TeamViewer on my desktop and it has recognized my mini PC. And of course, I have named my mini PC Astro 4. And you can use TeamViewer for free actually, so that's pretty nice. And you can also see that you can remote connect to your mini PC even before you are logged in to your mini PC. So here you can just see my startup screen and you can log on, and then here you will have of course the desktop. And I just wanted to show you all of the software that I have been installing on this thing. And yeah, you can see here, I have here set up Astro Gear, a subfolder, and I have put all of my the programs that I use into that subfolder. So first, let's start with Ascom Platform 64. So this is just a general Ascom driver that you need to download to remote connect to your mount. And for every mount, this will be the same. You can just download it from the Ascom website. And oh yeah, there's one thing. So the Ascom platform driver also needs this one, the .NET 3.5 setup. And most of the time people already have that installed in their regular Windows 7 or Windows 10 setup. But if you do not have installed this thing, then Ascom will remind you that you need to install this actually. So after installing the general Ascom driver, you also have to install the particular driver that is suited for your particular mount. So in my case, I'm using the Celestron AVX still. I'm planning on buying another mount, guys, but still I'm using the Celestron AVX. And it's giving me a hard time actually, because it has a lot of backlash right now. But anyway, so you can also go to like a specific page of the Ascom website, and you can download the telescope driver that is suited for your particular mount. So if you're a Celestron, you can download the Celestron driver. If you have a Skywatcher or an Ioptron mount, you can download one of those drivers, etc. Yeah, and then the third thing for my mount is that I also use Next Remote. And I will just quickly show you, this is also free to use. And maybe there's a better program for a Celestron mount. So if you know a better program, let me know. But this is the way I have been doing it for quite a while. So you can see here, I'm now set up. And I'm using Next Remote, which is actually some kind of a virtual hand controller. So I have switched on my AVX right now. So I can just here click on Enter. So set the mount to the North Celestial Pole, basically. So the parking mode. You can press Enter, and then it asks about your time, your daylight saving or your regular time, depending on what time of the year it is. I'm at time zone 1, Amsterdam time, basically. It asks you to enter the date, but after you have done this once, it will remember, of course, all of these things, and it will get the date from your computer. And yeah, what I've been doing lately is just click on last alignment and press Enter. And then I have successfully set up my Celestron AVX. And yeah, I'm not engaging anymore in this 4 or 6 star align process. It saves me a lot of time, and I know that when I have polar aligned my telescope correctly, then yeah, it usually guides pretty well, or pretty well given that this is a Celestron AVX. Anyway, so this is all the software I use for my mount.
So let's continue. Yeah, the most of you already probably use PhD2 for your guiding. I can show it to you anyway. So let's just quickly show you PhD2. And I will not get into a tutorial right now. That would take too much time, but you can see here. It needs a ZWO ASI camera driver. I will get into that later on. But you can see here, I can connect it to my guide scope. I have to take care not to connect it to my imaging camera. I did that a couple of times, basically. And then in Sequence Generator Pro, you cannot connect to your imaging camera again anyway. And of course, you have to connect using the telescope driver, the ESCOM telescope driver of your particular mount. So let's connect to both of them. Oh, okay. It gave me a little bit of lag here. Yep, and now I can just, I'm connected, so I can close this window and I can just loop here. And you can see it is very cloudy right now, so you can only see some gray skies. It's during the daytime. And this is the way how I connect my gear to PhD2. Okay, let's continue then with, I'm using Sequence Generator Pro to capture all of my images. And of course, I'm not using the free version, but I think there is like a 30 or 40 day trial period still for Sequence Generator Pro. And of course, I also see a lot of other people using Astrophotography Tool, APT, and I think that one is free. But I really, really like Sequence Generator Pro because it has such a big kind of functionality. You can do very versatile things in Sequence Generator Pro, which I will not get into right now. But anyway, you can see here I have set up a sequence and I just connect to my ZWO 1600 Mono Pro camera. I can connect remotely to my ZWO filter wheel and I can connect to my Celestron telescope driver. Yeah, that's it. And of course, I can set up a sequence and start imaging. And let's go out of Sequence Generator Pro again. Bye bye. Zwaai zwaai. I do not want to remember the session. Right. Oh yeah, and then there are two things related to Sequence Generator Pro actually. So you can see here the setup APM catalog.execute file and this one, the UCA 3PS zip file. Actually, you need to install both of those files if you also want to use plate solving in Sequence Generator Pro. And I would highly recommend you to do so because it saves you a lot of time finding targets in the night sky. And I have a separate video basically on how to set up plate solving. So, and I will provide a link to the website where you can download both of those files actually. Let's see, I'm also using SharpCap. So SharpCap, I'm using that particularly for two things. Oh, I clicked on the execute file. That is not what I wanted. Well, let's fire up SharpCap, currently in version 3.2. I think that's the most updated version at the moment. All right. And yeah, I can just connect, of course, my camera to SharpCap. And you have a free version and a paid version. And the paid version is about $15 or like 15 euros for every year, I guess. But anyway, I really, really, really like SharpCap. Let's optimize the quality of my screen here. Because of this polar align procedure, which is really, really useful, I think it's very useful. I always use it to polar align my mount. And of course, I'm also using SharpCap to make short videos of the moon and the planets in our own solar system. I'm basically using SharpCap for that. Let's switch it off again. And then I, of course, have TeamViewer set up, as I told you. And I'm missing one thing here. Oh yeah, this is, first of all, I have to also tell you the ZWO things you need. So I'm using ZWO cameras and the ZWO electronic filter wheel. So on their site, you can find a ZWO ASI camera ESCOM driver and a ZWO camera driver, and you need to install both of them. So both the driver and the driver for ESCOM are needed in order to make it working with your software. In this case, I'm using PhD2 and Sequence Generator Pro. And I also use the 8-position electronic filter wheel, and I have downloaded here the ESCOM driver for that. to just connect to my filter wheel in Sequence Generator Pro. And you also have an alternative. You can also use your guide camera. You use the USB ST4 connection, so you can put a cable in your guide camera and then put another the other end of the cable into your auto guide input on your mount. This is also a way to guide, but most astronomers, they have told me that the SCOM connection is far superior to using a USB ST4 connection. So I'm always using this SCOM connection to my mount. Yeah, basically this is all I have for you, so you know a little bit what kind of software that I'm using. Ah, I forgot one thing. Of course, I'm also using Stellarion. So I think you probably already know this, but let's fire Stellarion up anyway. So you have here Stellarion. And let's fast forward a little bit. Yep. Oh, that's too fast. I'm always impatient and I click one time too many. More or less. So it's dark right now. Yep. So here you can actually also connect your telescope to Stellarion. So that's also what I'm using sometimes. So you can set up Stellarion to recognize your mount. I also have another video on that, a pretty old one actually, where my pronunciation of the English is even worse than this video. This is Dutch version, but I'm connected right now to my telescope, and you can see that it recognizes my scope as being parked in, so it's pointing to the north celestial pole basically. And what you can do is then just select a particular target, for instance the moon, and you press Control 1 and or Command 1 if you have a Mac, of course, or some kind of, and there we go. So you can see here the telescope is now automatically slewing to the position where the moon will be if it would be 9:30 tonight. But anyway, this is also pretty useful. I'm using Stellarion together with SharpCap a lot, just to get my mount positioned on the moon or the some of the planets, and then I use SharpCap to further capture videos of that particular target. And then I'm not using Sequence Generator Pro at all if I am collecting videos or pictures on the moon and the planets. I'm just using Stellarion and SharpCap for that. So, that's everything I wanted to show you actually. So I hope you have you got some value out of this video. If you did, please consider giving this video a thumbs up and subscribing to the channel. And I hope you stay safe and I hope you will stay healthy during these bizarre times, I have to say. And with all that in mind, I of course hope that I can see you next time on the next video of Astroforum. And until then I want to wish you clear skies.